Hello and welcome back to Media Dialogues with Storyboard 18, where we are digging into the transformation of customer experience from a cost center to a profit center. Let me just maybe switch tracks a little bit here, and feel free if anybody would like to take it, and talk about sort of, you know, a data-centric approach to also measuring the impact of your CX initiatives. You know, how do you approach that? I mean, if feel free to take that question. Please go on.
So voice of the customer is the starting point for us. So everything that we do throughout the customer journey, we try to listen to the customer. We have our ears open. We want to understand what the customer needs. And it is not really in terms of what we want to give to the customer. It's a balance between what they want and what we give, right? And the timing, I said, is very, very important of when to implement what things. In terms of technology, there is a lot of technology available in the market today, but is your customer ready throughout the journey to accept that as a technology or an interface? Because in our case, like I said, the personas would be different. There would be, since we are an interior fittings company, it could be an architect, it could be an interior designer, there could be carpenters who are the influencers for us. So it is very important for us to have a mix of everything and give that option to the customer.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
A little addition or probably a little difference of opinion probably I would like to bring it over here is the way we are measuring customer experience these days. Most of the organizations which have taken step to this move towards measuring NPS, okay, which is defined as the currently the gold standard for measuring your customer experience.
Yes.
My belief is that is fairly reactive in nature because you are going back to the customer after the incident or after the interaction has happened, mm-hmm. trying to figure out how did you fare. So it's fairly reactive. I believe it's a little unfocused because you are actually not able to get the sharp insight unless and until you take an additional effort of going back to customers and asking if the customers are actually not very happy with your service. It is also very ambiguous mm-hmm. right now. And therefore, the need is to move to something which is fairly predictive in nature rather than reactive. It also needs that something that is actually very much tied back to the ROI. Unfortunately, what happens is all the investments you want to make in CX, we as CX professional are not able to build in the ROI
connect
with the ROI. And therefore, that probably is not always on the focus.
Mm-hmm.
The moment you are able to build an ROI focus into it, so make it predictive, make an ROI focus, make it all encompassing
mm-hmm.
so that it covers the entire organization. These things, if done properly, and I'm sure there are a lot of technological tools which are available, which are coming in now,
yeah.
which will really help us to get over there.
Right.
How do
right.
you define CX?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the question, to me, it's a foundational question, right?
Absolutely.
Because, you know, historically, CX was more, I call into a call center, I have my issue resolved, did I have a good experience, you know, what rating would I give? The agent will say, sir, we'll send you an SMS, can you please, you know, rate me, and 9 on 10 is preferred, right? That was foundationally CX. But if you think about it today, CX starts from your first touch point with the company, even before you become a customer, right? We're dealing with a very large customer, you know, they're in the automotive sector, but they're saying, we don't want to be known as an automotive company. We want to be known as an experience company.
Interesting. Wow.
Okay? Mm-hmm. And so I was like, okay, that's a completely different paradigm because they're saying, you know, if they engage with us and they feel the experience is different, they will buy everything that we're there, you know, to offer to them. And mm-hmm. so I think customer experience now has taken on a completely different, you know, in my view, avatar, in the sense that you could easily attribute your top line, you could attribute lead conversion, you could attribute one of 10 different things before somebody becomes a customer,
yeah.
right, to CX initiatives. Today, the simplicity with which I can buy something, right, is the number one reason why I would want to work with a particular organization,
exactly.
right? Have you ever been to an Apple store, mm. right? How simple do they
Very
make
definition.
It at the time of billing, right? You walk around, they come with a simple mobile device, they scan the QR code, your credit card is swiped, and you're out.
Mm-hmm.
The customer experience piece is not after the fact. Today, it's starting well before somebody's actually become your customer.
Mm-hmm.
How do you draw them in? And so I think the whole paradigm is shifting, and which is why if you see a lot of companies today are investing a lot in the experience upfront, knowing that if they get that right, the rest of it will fall in place. Yeah.
Well, thank you so much, gentlemen. It was lovely chatting with you. It was a very illuminating chat, so lots to take out. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
You've heard how critical it is to create a customer-centric culture to drive business growth in times when technology and customers are fast evolving. The transformation of customer experience is that engine of growth, taking CX from what used to be a cost center to a profit center. And on that note, we'll say goodbye and see you again on the next Media Dialogue with Storyboard 18. Thank you for watching.